Good morning and welcome to Palm Sunday at First Church of Christ. We're really glad that you're here today and that you have made time in your weekly schedule, especially around this time of year, to say, Lord, I'm going to celebrate you. Palm Sunday is built around the word Hosanna, which means the Lord saves. So could you say that word with me? Hosanna. Hosanna. You just said the Lord saves. And how many of you believe that today? Yeah. All right. Amen. Great, so let's get started as we worship the Lord. Would you stand with us as we sing together?
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope.
Pour out our praise, it's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, it's your breath in our lungs, so we pour.
also look forward to Sunday, realizing that you overcame and you conquered. We know without question, Father, that the Lord saves. And all of his people say unto the Lord, Amen. You may be seated.
Suddenly articulate with the power.
As we prepare for communion, I'd like to read from Isaiah 33:17. It says, "Your eyes will see the King and His beauty, and view a land that stretches afar." You know, once again, we behold the beauty of spring and the variety of colors we see in nature. In the Midwestern United States, spring is an occasion for the robin's return. We appreciate the robin's reddish-orange underside. Let us rejoice in nature's colors. Then let us think of the beauty of Jesus in terms of colors. Red reminds us of His blood shed for our sins. White symbolizes His purity. Green speaks of the new life and thereby represents the newness of the life we gain through His atonement. Blue, the color of heaven, is a reminder of the heavenly Jerusalem being prepared by Jesus as an eternal home for us. In the Lord's Supper, we behold the beauty of Jesus. The whiteness of the loaf and the red of the juice symbolizes purity and His sacrifice. In the words, "Do this in remembrance of me," we perceive the beauty of His gracious invitation to commune with Him. As we partake, we enjoy a moment of beautiful unity, sharing in the one loaf and the one cup. The reminders of His beauty are all around us. Let us behold in awe and in gratitude. Let us pray then. Father, we do thank You for all the beautiful things You prepare or give to us each and every day, and just how wonderful You are. But most of all, Father, as we gather around the Lord's table here, we just take this time to remember You and thank You for the things You do in our lives, for each one of us. And most of all, we thank You for Your Son, our Lord and Savior. In His name we do pray, amen. If you would please join us, we have communion prepared here in the front and the back. Thank you.
Today we celebrate both Calvary's Lamb sacrificed for our sins and the risen Savior who defeated death. We give thanks for the great mercy that sent him to a rugged tree in our place and the great power that raised him from the dead.
In the days after the Lord's resurrection, we couldn't get enough of hearing the stories his followers shared. John and I would tell how we had raced to the tomb and found it empty. And then Thomas would tell about falling at the Master's feet and declaring, "My Lord and my God." With each testimony that was given, our murmurs would grow into great shouts of joy. because we had all experienced his goodness and love.
We're all on a journey, and we're called to walk by faith. There'll always be the mountains and valleys in our way. But right here in this moment, may our strength be renewed as we recall what God has done and how we've seen him move. If there's anybody here who's found him faithful, anybody here who knows he's able, say amen. If there's anybody here who's seen his power, anybody here brought through the fire, say amen. Anybody here found joy in the midst of sorrow, peace in the storm, hope for tomorrow, and you've seen it time and time again, just say amen.
Sometimes through the darkness, it gets hard to see, but be bold and courageous and follow where he leads. Greater is the one who's in us than he who's in the world. So child of God, remember the battle is the Lord.
If there's anybody here who's found him faithful, anybody here who knows he's able, say amen. If there's anybody here who's seen his power, anybody here walk through the fire, say amen. Anybody here found joy in the midst of sorrow, peace in the storm, hope for tomorrow, and you've seen it time and time again, just say amen. Just stand and testify of God in our lives.
If there's anybody here who's found him faithful, anybody here who knows he's able, to say amen. If there's anybody here who's seen his power, anybody here brought through the fire, say amen. Anybody here found joy in the midst of sorrow, peace in the storm, hope for tomorrow, and you've seen it time and time again, just say amen. Just say amen. Just say
had good reason to believe Jesus was mightier than death itself, it was my sister and brother and I. Lazarus had been buried 4 days when Jesus arrived. My grief was overwhelming, and my disappointment in the Master for not coming sooner was deep. But I will always remember the words he said just before he called my brother from the grave. I am the resurrection and the life. I can tell you for certain, Jesus is our resurrection. He is our hope. He is our answer to every problem. I love Jesus the way only one who has been rescued from torment and death could love. At the cross, I grieved for him because he was my Lord and Master, and because he was completely guiltless. In the garden that morning, my sorrow overflowed when we discovered his body gone. But in one moment, agony turned to victory and heartbreak to joy.
Jesus said what we must do to be his disciples. His message came down to two words: follow me. We follow by obeying him, by seeking his will, by doing it, and by praying for his kingdom to come. Here are the words he gave me for those who want this life. If you declare with your mouth, Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved. This is your opportunity to follow him today.
Thank you.
In the years following his ascension, I, John, lived long enough to watch as his apostles were martyred one by one for their faith in Jesus. Some were stoned, some beheaded, some crucified. I endured banishment and imprisonment and torture. Yet I rejoice to be counted worthy to be persecuted for his sake, because I believed his promise. One day we would see him. One day he would welcome us into his presence. One day heaven would be real.
One day you'll make everything new, Jesus. One day you will bind every wound. The former things shall all pass away, no more tears. One day you'll make sense of it all, Jesus. One day every question resolved. Every anxious
Well, we want to thank everyone for coming today and just thank Marie and all the choir members for their hard work putting this together. We were going to have it last year, and we got to have it this year, and a lot of the words really hit well this year, so hopefully it was an encouragement to you. We're going to show a video of this time, just a short, quick video that encourages you to invite someone next week for our Easter service. So let's watch that video together. We will have overflow seating down in the CLC for both services, so we will be able to social distance and that sort of thing. But keep that in mind for next week. Also, Thursday night is our Maudy Thursday service, our communion service. We encourage you to come out for that. The choir will be singing. We've got some worship. And then remember, I ask you to think of something that you haven't surrendered to God if you haven't, and we'll be prepared to write that down and commit that, surrender that to God. So keep that in mind for Thursday. Also, our Sunday school will start today at about 10:10, so encourage you to stay for Sunday school if you can. A reminder, T-shirts, we're a little bit over 100. We need to get to 144, so if you haven't signed up yet, please sign up for a T-shirt. Let's stand and we'll pray. Dear Lord, we just thank you so much for this day that we've had to sing these songs to you, such wonderful words that share your story. You are an awesome God, and we just thank you so much for our choir members who worked so hard throughout the past couple of months to prepare this, to do it to your glory. Again, we thank you for Marie and for the sound people and everyone that played a part. We just thank you for the love and service of others, so that we can have a day like this where we truly praise your name. Lord, we do lift up this week our Easter services. We lift them up to you. May they be done to your glory as well. We pray for those on our prayer list, Lord, for those who are hurting. We ask that you give them strength and joy and comfort and peace. And we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Have a great week. Thank you.